Hello guys, welcome to my fourth class of Laplace Transfer. We discussed already in the previous few of classes some important standard function of Laplace Transfer. Before going to listen this video, better you write some standard function in your one of book or pages like that, then easy to understand today's class. Now, I want to find out Laplace Transform of e power of at into psi pt. Instead of applying the direct definition of Laplace transform, I am going to take one of the properties called shifting property. What's our shifting property says? Now I want to find out Laplace transform of e power of at into sine of bt. Now the shifting property. Now shifting property says that Laplace transform of e power of at into what actually f of t is nothing but f of s minus a. First you find out Laplace transform of sine bt. Therefore, we know that Laplace transform of sin bt, we discussed in the last class, is nothing but b by a square plus b square. The next, by shifting property, no need to write that property. Now, shifting property is nothing but if Laplace transform of f of t is equal to capital F of s, then the shifting property is e power of at into f of t is nothing but f of s minus a. Yes, by just you write the name of that formula, by shifting property we get Laplace transform of e power of at into sin bt is nothing but what actually b by, instead of s, what we are going to replace, s minus a, s minus a whole square plus b square. Now instead of finding directly, now I am taking the shifting property, we get very easily. That's why you adopt some properties. Not only Laplace, you go to the Fourier transform, Z transform, everywhere they have a property. This is the beauty of the properties of the corresponding transform. Similarly, I want to find out Laplace transform of e power of at cos bt. Therefore, first you have to find out right, what is Laplace transform of cos bt. From the standard formula, this is s by s square plus b square. By shifting property, now without mentioning the name of the property, you can't proceed for the step. Keep in mind, you must and should not mention the name of the property before going to apply that. Laplace transform of e power of at cos of pt is nothing but, instead of s, what we are going to replace is minus a divided by s minus a whole square plus b square. Now this is nothing but Laplace second function. Similarly, I want to find out Laplace transform of e power of at into sine hyperbolic of bt. First you have to write, what is Laplace transform of sine hyperbolic bt? We discussed in the previous class that is treated as a standard function value. This is nothing but b by a square minus b square. Now, by shifting property, now see, before I went up all five functions, every must and should have to thorough with that. What's the meaning of how to apply shifting property? What's the meaning of the shifting property? What's the use of the shifting property? Now, Laplace transform of e power of bt sine hyperbolic of bt is nothing but, instead of s, what we are going to replace, s minus a whole square minus b square. Now, similarly, now I have to take Laplace transform of cos hyperbolic at bt. Now, what's the formula now? S by s square minus b square. This implies by shifting property, now I write s dot p, don't write s dot p, that is not a standard notation. My convenience simply written s p, please write it full name shifting property. What we get, Laplace transform of, what is that? E power of a t into cos hyperbolic of p t is nothing but replace s by s minus a divided by s minus a whole square minus b square. Now I am going to take here for just change e power of minus a. Now Laplace transform of t power of a, you already know that. Now I am going to treat it as an integer. For time being, is nothing but n factorial divided by x to the power n plus 1. This implies by shifting property, what we get actually? Laplace transform of e power of minus at into t power of n is nothing but n factorial divided by I to replace s by s minus of s plus to the power of n plus 1. This I need to find out Laplace transform of what actually e power of minus at into t power of n. Next, moving to how to find out Laplace transform of sin 2t, sin 3t. I think everyone is clear now, everyone is familiar with how to apply shifting property, what's the use of shifting property, how they get easily from shifting property required solution of the given function by in the Laplace transform. Now, moving to the next function, that function is sin 2t, sin 3t. Now we can't find out directly product of two trigonometric functions. We are not discussing standard formula for product of two trigonometric functions. Now we are going to use transformation formula and you convert product of two trigonometric functions in terms of sum or difference of their trigonometric function. The transformation formula is 2 sin A into sin B is nothing but cos of A minus B minus of cos of A plus B. Now everyone, you know, you already studied in PU level transformation formula. In case you forgotten, I have written already what's a transformation formula. Now from this formula, now Laplace transform the form, what is my A 2t, what is my B is 3t. Laplace transform, which one is missing? 1 by 2. Therefore I take 2 cross multiplication, 1 by 2 of cos of my A is 2t, okay. What is my B? 3t. Cos of A minus B means cos of minus t. 2t minus 3t. Minus cos of A plus B. 2 plus 3 is 5t. Okay. Now, I am going to use linear property now. Here, from the linear property, what we get? Half of Laplace transform cos of minus theta. What is cos of minus theta? Is cos theta. Minus, I keep my 1 by 2 outside for both the terms common, minus Laplace transform of cos of 5t. This is possible from which property? Linear property. Linear property. Okay. Next, we are going to apply one of the standard formula. What is the formula? Is cos at. We know that before going to apply the formula, better I to write the formula, then I have to avoid the mistake. Cos at is nothing but what actually? S divided by a square plus a square. Now, from this, alpha, in the first thing, what is my a? A is 1. A is equal to 1. Now we get s by a square plus 1 minus. In the second one, what is 5a? A is 5. S by a square plus 5 square. What is 5 square? Is 25. Now, if you want to simplify further, not necessary to simplify because just asking to find Laplace transform of product of two trigonometric functions. How to find out Laplace? The up to this step, the fundamental steps, you already know that. Now, we can't find out product of two functions. Now I have to find out, I have to convert the product of two trigonometric functions. They must be in the form of sum or difference of two trigonometric functions by using the transformation formula. After that, using standard formula for cos at, finally we get Laplace transform of sin 2t, sin 3t. Similarly, to try for product of sin and cos, cos and sin, sin a cos b, cos a sin b, cos A, cos B, like that similar type problem you pick it from any textbook, you find out. In all the case, first you have to write the transformation formula. Better you write transformation or formula for cos A, cos B, sin A, sin B, cos A, sin B, sin A, cos B in that separate book, then easy to solve. Thank you very much for listening my talk. I'll continue the rest of the problems in my further videos. If you like my videos, please give a like and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much for listening once again my talk.